But I've also heard, if I'm not mistaken, she during the initial phase of her career, she was not that confident of herself. I mean, is it true?
See, I think Madhuri, unlike many of the other girls and boys who enter the film industry, has come with no ego. She is a student, she's a learner, and as a result of which, she doesn't come with a cocky quality, which sometimes helps a lot of people because they probably are so insecure themselves, but they have this air of cockiness, and therefore people begin to believe that, you know, what confidence? Madhuri's confidence is internal. She comes from an extremely happy family. Her home life, her mother, her sisters, brother. She comes from a very secure background. And as a result of which, she doesn't, therefore, have any kind of mental or psychological problems. But when it comes to doing something new, she is willing to learn. She doesn't come with any preconceived notions about, you know, I'm going to do this, or this is the way I'm going to, you know, project myself. That's why when Kajol once said something about it, she is by far India's greatest director's actress. Because she imbibes what the director has in mind, and then she adds her own little bit, and she brings it out. Therefore, Madhuri responds best to instruction, to suggestion, and to a little bit of background. So one of the finest qualities about Madhuri is that she's an eternal student.
As you said that during the initial phase of her career, I mean, we all of us know that many of her films flopped. They didn't work, like Abodh and Swati. These films didn't work. So
I
you were there.
would, in fact, I would say this about Madhuri, that she was always willing to experiment. Yes, I've shot her before Tezab, and I've shot her post Devdas and post Aaja Nachle. And the one thing that I find is, okay, now there's a photo session to be done. She is yours. Tell me what to do, and I will try and do my best. And I think that's one of the reasons why, even though her beauty and her glamour comes through, there is never that conceit or arrogance. And that is why Madhuri is liked. Because along with her beauty comes a certain amount of warmth, which she communicates through the lens, whether it's cinematography or whether it's photographs. There is a certain warmth, the communication with her fans, with her public, which I think has taken her a long way.
And as you said, you were talking about experiments. During the initial phase of her career, she experimented with a controversial scene in Daya One. How did that scene affect her?
I don't think she liked it very much because that's not something that she repeated again. But again, the true professional, she did what she was asked to do. I don't even know whether she ever made clear that she wasn't happy doing things. And knowing her very well, we never pushed her to a point where she would say, feel that, oh, you know, this is really, I'm not feeling comfortable. Because you didn't have to, you know, there was so much in the eyes, and there was so much in her expression, and there was so much in her smile, and there was so much of variety. Because when a person has a very protean face or a very malleable face with a infinite supply of expressions, then I really don't think that you need to gild the lily by, you know, by making it look sexy or trying to load her with too many jewelry or clothes. In fact, Madhuri's face does not take too much jewelry. She's got a small face. She's very proportionate in that 5'4" form of hers. And I think less is more for her. The lesser you decorate her, the lesser you dress her up, the more appealing she is.
During the initial phase of her career, how was her resolve to become actress? You know, you spotted her before she was the person she is now in terms of the star she is.
I think Madhuri really never worked towards an ambition or a goal. She just kept on, okay, this is work to be done. I want to do it. I like it. I'm going to do it. You see, I do feel that ambition is all right for people who are actually quite limited. You know, you want to go from point A to point C, or point C to point D. But when you consider it as a passion, something that you love doing, you love dancing, you love acting, you love performing, and you've got a great nature to get along with your directors, with your co-artists, I think you go far beyond your ambitions. She has reached her dreams. And that again is a part of a very, very nice and a very balanced mental makeup.
And how did Teja and Indothin change life?
Not at all. I don't think any of Madhuri's... I mean, she was one of the very lucky ones who, right from Tezab and then Ram Lakhan and then Dil and then she, Khalnayak, every year the biggest hit of the year for almost 8 or 10 years used to be hers. Then, of course, Hab Aapke Hai Kaun and Dil To Pagal Hai. I mean, every year for almost 12 years, the biggest hit of the year, the commercial hit, used to be Madhuri's. But I don't think it changed an iota. And you can cross-check this with all her colleagues, her hairstylists, her makeup artists, even people, her dress designers. She was never demanding. She was always grateful for what she got. And she never had any airs.